yeah, just makes them happy. We did so much.
That is used to be that dark room where I would do my sewing tutorials. My desk used to be here.
Welcome back to another vlog. Today is a big day. We have appointments. We're celebrating our anniversary. My son is turning 6 months and you're gonna meet him. I wanna introduce you guys. So I'm gonna get him ready for the day and then probably bring him back to meet you guys. I'm finally gonna reveal the basement. Not all the stuff is in it yet. It's not fully decorated, but you're going to see the final results of our renovation. So we do have actually his 6 month pediatrician appointment. We are celebrating our anniversary. Oh, hello, Harley. You guys have probably missed her. Come. Oh, she's been doing good. She loves him. Maybe you'll see their dynamic a little bit today. But yeah, we're celebrating our anniversary. It's been 4 years of marriage. So amazing. So we're going to a nice restaurant for that, which I have to get ready for at some point. And a painter is coming today at some point to finish up the basement. And what else? Just the typical baby nap routine, all of that. So I'm gonna be bringing you guys along for a lot of that. But thank you for tuning in. I hope that this is enjoyable. I don't know yet if this is going to be long or short. Typically I plan out my vlogs almost meticulously, but this one is gonna be a little bit more on the fly. I'm trying something new, which is difficult for me. So hopefully you like it. I just want to show you off. They miss you. Your fans miss you. They miss you. She's been doing so good. She loves him. She loves Bodhi. And he loves her, and that's great, but there's a big size difference. And so when he's on his belly doing tummy time, he'll kind of like try to reach for her, and she wants to cuddle him. So there's been a couple times where I'm like, no, don't sit on the baby. And of course she likes to give him kisses. She got a little bit, I think, anxious when he started moving around a little more. I think she thought, I thought he was stationary. Like, what's happening? So we worked through that. I mean, she's great. I followed an Instagram account called Dog Meets Baby for a few months before like Bodhi was born, and gave me a lot of great tips. I mean, she's kind of an amazing dog, like kind of one of the best dogs out there. I mean, she adjusted really, really well. I don't think we did anything that special with her, other than still giving her a ton of attention. He started petting her when he was like a little less than 4 months old, because I would be holding him on my lap, and when she'd cruise by, he would reach out, and then when he touched her fur, he would start like, you know, feeling the texture of it. So he really loves her, and that just makes my heart so happy. my son. He's everything. He's so cute. I've not really seen us together on camera before, so I keep looking at us, and I'm sorry. I will look at you guys. So, yeah, I don't know. He's just gorgeous. You can see he's healthy. His blonde hair is coming in. When he was born, he had really dark hair. Maybe we'll show some newborn pics over here. But he is growing. He can play with toys now. He's been rolling both ways for a while. He sleeps on his belly. He sleeps pretty good, usually through the night. I mean, he's a joy. He is kind of busy. So if anyone has advice for entertaining very active, interactive babies, I would more than appreciate it. His favorite toy is his Jolly Jumper. He loves his activity center, tummy time. But you know, you just kind of gotta like keep the activities rolling with him because he does get bored easily. Thankfully, if nothing else is working, I do know that I can take him for a walk outside and he'll just be calm and look out at nature. He loves being outside. I mean, I said in my other video, but he's not gonna be this small forever. So I'm just like, ah! I keep thinking about the fact that like there will be a last time that I can carry him. You know, I can like hold him, you know, like that. So I just try to cuddle him and hold him as much as possible. And yeah, he says hello. I mean, babies can't really say much to you guys other than hi. Every day I try to make him have a belly laugh because I think everyone should laugh at least once a day. So we had some laughter this morning. We're gonna hopefully have more soon. Yeah. We've been using these side snap onesies and I do really like them. I think I'll link them below. This one has a bit of dog hair on it, as most things do in our home. But yeah, he likes standing. He tried to stand like this even as a newborn. As a newborn, he would try to stand in the bathtub. So it was really, or not the bathtub, the sink. And it was really hard to bathe him because he would just like shoot up out of the water. Yes, you were so hard to bathe. You were so hard to bathe. You were so hard to bathe. He loves when I make like weird noises, like yeah, it just makes him happy. He loves his mama. He does sometimes get cranky if somebody else is with him and it's not me. I mean, it kind of makes my heart happy a little bit because it's like, oh, he knows I'm mom. And I've never had that before. So yeah, I don't know. It's just going really well. Yes. So he's been very patient with this YouTube video. So I'm going to go do some fun things for him and then I'll probably show you the basement. So this situation used to be when you came down the stairs, there was a wall to that point on the wall. So like right here, and that's where our sauna is. And that is used to be that dark room where I would do my sewing tutorials. My desk used to be here. I used to have an ironing board on the back wall. That's our storage room. So that was a separate room. So we decided to remove that wall and essentially create
instead of having this half of the basement be the open side, which it used to be, there used to be no wall right here, we made it long, like lengthwise. So the entire thing feels way bigger than it used to, which is really amazing. And another reason we removed the wall.
Before, when there was a wall here, you kind of couldn't do much in this room. And then you kind of had like the furniture here, and we used to have the TV and the kitty corner. So now that there's all this wall is removed, we have tons of play space, which was my goal. This is actually an enormous amount of space. And you would not believe how quickly Bodhi has progressed towards crawling just because of this really nice comfy carpet. It was very cabiny. There was paneling everywhere, if you don't remember. But then this was all open, and there was just kind of like a no man's land over there.
We didn't really use that space at all. This games table was back there, and then there was just kind of like this random spot. And so when we decided we wanted to add a bedroom and a bathroom, specifically because when we have guests over, sharing a bathroom with everybody is kind of horrible. And we wanted more room, more freedom, more space. And we had this dead space in our basement. So we egressed a window and we added a closet, and those are the two requirements for being able to claim an extra bedroom, like if you were to go to sell. So it's a full-on bedroom. We are so happy. It turned out gorgeous. It's actually one of the brightest rooms in our house, which is so funny. It's in the basement. But the bathroom turned out great. It's pretty big, and I have yet to decorate it. I have yet to decorate a lot of this.
Basically, this section is done. We kept the shelves that we used to have in the basement. My husband actually picked out this TV, what are they called? TV stand, TV console thing, and it's fits everything perfectly. We bought some new lamps. We're gonna put some movie posters here. So far, we have Star Wars Episode 2. Like the prequels. We are unashamed. We like the prequels. It brings us back to our childhoods because we grew up when those movies came out, and it's just a cozy memory. We have the Lord of the Rings because I love Lord of the Rings so much. And then we're going to have another poster here that's coming soon. And then we have our old couch. We were going to spring for a new couch, but we just decided to save some money for a while, and then we'll get a sectional or something beige or gray to just kind of like blend with the area.
Our goal is to have a new couch by Thanksgiving because we're probably going to be hosting Thanksgiving for my husband's side of the family. So that's our goal. We're going to be moving around things a little bit, but this TV area is pretty much finny.
So you can access the guest bedroom through the own door or through the bathroom, which is fabulous. So walking through here, it really is so well lit. Like this is without any lights on, but I really love this room. I'm going to have fun decorating this. I'm gonna have fun decorating this. I just know that we're gonna probably put a queen bed in here at some point. There's gonna be a headboard. The parrots look great. The window's actually great. I don't know.
This room is just pretty straightforward. In fact, I feel like the lighting is almost good enough I could film a commentary video on it. So I'm gonna have fun. Guest rooms, you know, they're not a huge priority, but it's nice for your guests to have a wonderful place to stay. And then bathroom. It's such a yellow light. In person, it's not that yellow, but beautiful.
I got these hand towels from Home Goods, and I love them. And I also got these from Home Goods. The trash, which is full of construction material, and the toilet bowl cleaner. I feel like adding a really nice trash and a fancy toilet bowl cleaner, but really elevates the overall bathroom. But that cleaner thing was only $12. Finally, our sauna is tucked away. You wouldn't even know there is something behind here, which is fabulous. So yeah, it's in there, the whole thing. And then we have my crafting area.
I feel like my sewing videos are gonna look so much nicer with this setup. It's honestly beautiful. So yeah, that's the basement. It was a labor of love on behalf of my husband. When I was postpartum, he had to be down here working on it. When we were struggling with sleep in those newborn days, he had to be down here working on it. We wanted to get it done before Bodhi was even born, but that's just not a possibility. If you guys are following anyone online who's renovating or building a house, contractors are super backed up. So it wasn't just us, but it was really touch and go there for a bit. But we finished it. We are so happy, and we use it a lot because it doubled the square footage of our home. And it's a great family space. It's a great crawling space for Bodhi. It's just wonderful. So yeah, this is the basement. We're really happy.
Have wanted to see how I do that. And so lucky for all of you, I kept my hair straight today and I was thinking of trimming it this week. So I'm gonna show you how I trim it. Now I'm not like a professional, I'm not a hairdresser. If you don't have my hair type, this might not work for you, but you wanted to see how I cut my hair. So I'm gonna show you. Okay, so this is my hair. And obviously it's dry. I showered this morning and it's parted kind of where I've been keeping my part lately. Not that that's really gonna matter because I'm not gonna mess around with my layers right now. I'm just going to trim the bottom. So this is how I trim my hair. So I brush it all forward. I make sure it's dry and pretty straight. You could flat iron it first, but I don't really feel the need because blow drying it makes it straight. My hair used to be like it used to curl and wave easily, and it used to hold a curl for a few days, but ever since I grew out my natural color and therefore my natural hair, it's not damaged, it's not dry, it's pretty moisturized and straight when I blow dry it. So you're gonna need straight hair cutting scissors. Don't do this with kitchen scissors. Don't do this with sewing scissors. Don't do this with random scissors. Hair cutting scissors are not even that expensive, and it's so much better for your hair because it'll get a nice, really clean cut. So I brush forward, and then I scoop all the hair forward as well. And then I pull it down really hard like this. You can see I have layers, so some of it's gonna come out, that doesn't matter. I pull it forward really hard and I hold my posture up well. I hold the crown of my head up, and then I go down with my fingers and I make sure it's even. And then I trim the bottom of it. Good. There you go. And that's all I do. I just make it even. I don't take off much. I used to, because you can see with my layers, right? So I used to have super layered hair, like a piece from back here, even just a few years ago. Like a piece like this would have only come down to like the back of my scalp. So it used to be this short. So I've had to grow my layers out like this much growth in the last few years. And I think the blunt cut I've been doing, just a little trim every couple months, has helped get rid of those layers, strengthen the bottom, because again, the bottom of my hair didn't used to be this thick. It used to be like, you know, when it used to kind of look like this, when I gathered all my hair together, it was like really thin. But because I've blunt cut it and grown it out, it's a lot thicker at the bottom. And it's growing out really nicely. So that's how I trim my hair. It is not complicated. So yeah, you guys can see it's pretty healthy. That's what the bottom kind of curls into. Gosh, I feel like really good hair that's kind of low maintenance is a wonderful way to look polished postpartum. And you guys know I love talking about how to look polished. So I got some vacuuming to do. Bubba's down for a nap. So, here.
anniversary, fancy anniversary dinner get ready with me. I have to do this so fast though, because our reservation is early, like 6:15, and the restaurant's an hour away because, like I said, we're going into the city. We just got back from the baby appointment, but I'm going to try to make this fast. I have forehead tape on because your girl has forehead wrinkles. They were growing during my pregnancy. I was trying to like moisturize. I don't think I'll end up getting Botox just because it kind of like makes me nervous, and it's expensive. So forehead tape temporarily works. I will link it below. It's not expensive. You can just stick it on for about 20 minutes to an hour before your event, and your face will literally smooth out. It's not like a long lasting thing, but it does kind of help. So anyways, I have the forehead tape on, the hair is curled. I've been liking kind of that Kate Middleton blowout look. It's nothing crazy, but you can see because of my trims, because of that healthy care I've been taking, the ends are shiny. If you look at my earlier videos, I shouldn't do makeup and chat at you guys. If you look at my earlier videos on YouTube, the ends of my hair, it was kind of rough. So we have come a long way. And if you want hair like this, I will link that account below. Her name is Audrey and I will link her below. She is incredible. All of her beauty secrets are amazing. So we are going to get going with makeup. Now I've been using this CC cream forever. It is almost out. If you guys know any influencers running like a 15% off collab or something with IT Cosmetics, leave the info below because I need to buy some, and a little 15% off would be kind of nice. But I just primed with my husband's aftershave because I heard from a makeup artist friend one time that you can use men's Nivea aftershave as a primer. And I don't use primer much. I only use it like for special events. And I don't know, I feel like a nice dinner that you drive an hour for and have babysitters is kind of a nice event. But it's not really babysitters, it's my aunt and my cousin. Like I said, my cousin was staying with us for a bit, helping me out. And then because I didn't have a lot of that foundation, I'm also gonna use my good old Lumi True Match. This is what I used when I first started YouTube. I used this foundation and I still really like it. It's just not as long lasting as the CC cream. And when you're a mother, I literally put my makeup on it like during his first nap, so 8 a.m., 8:15, and that makeup has gotta last me till 8:15 p.m. So I like the long lasting coverage. But yeah, so his appointment went really well. He's right on his growth chart for his head, his height, his weight. He's not a big baby, he's not a small baby, he's just a healthy baby. Okay, I discovered this concealer. You can see too, it's almost an empty. I use my stuff before I tell you guys about it. This is the Age Perfect L'Oreal Radiance Concealer. I started using a concealer after having a baby because I had some sleepless nights. So I put it on my chin, around my nose, and then on my nose. I just leave my forehead till the end. I have freckles, so I don't usually put makeup on my forehead. Also, I brought this over to show you. This is the self-tanner I've been using. It has no parabens, phthalates, or synthetic fragrances, which is hard to find in a self-tanner. And it actually works. I use it on my face and it hasn't caused a breakout. So I'm gonna recommend it and I'll leave the info below. After that, we're gonna go in with some bronzer. This is the Rimmel London Natural Bronzer. I don't know about you guys, but Rimmel has disappeared from my Walmart. I don't know if they're going through like a rebrand or something, but guys, come back. I need to buy you your bronzer. So yeah, I just put that on my cheekbones. You can see it makes a big difference. Now that I'm getting older, I am losing some baby fat in my face, which sad, like baby fat makes you look young. But it makes it easier to contour my face for sure. And then I'm just gonna put it under there. I'm gonna put a little bit on my nose. There we go. Even with the talking, this is going by very quickly. I gotta run and grab the eyeshadow palette. For eyeshadow, we're gonna be using Honest Beauty. A subscriber kept sending Honest Beauty. I think her name's Erica, if I'm remembering correctly. Erica from Albany, but she moved to Denver. She kept sending me Honest beauty products, and she's not like a rep for them or anything, but she totally got me on the train. I love this eyeshadow palette. Would recommend. It's honestly lasted better than a lot of eyeshadow palettes I've had, and the colors are great, especially if you have blue eyes. It's fantastic for blondes. Very flattering. So I'm gonna go ahead and add brown on my lid. Whenever I wear a bit more of a smoky eye, my husband always compliments me. So I think he might like to see the smoky eye come out tonight. I mean, he's the one who has to sit across from me at dinner. It's kind of rough, but I just kind of put the color on there. Like, I guess my makeup get ready with me's are good for people who like have no idea what they're doing with makeup, because I kind of have no idea, but I just do very simple stuff. So I feel like people can follow what I'm doing. Okay, now I'm gonna take that same color and put it under my eye. Yeah, so I like to bring up my eye a little bit, and I have eyes that have a lot of white space under my iris. So having like a darker color underneath kind of gives me that doll look, which I think is kind of nice. Oh, and while we have the palette out, we can carve out my nose. Okay, this is kind of a fun trick. You can see the shadows of my nose right here and here. So we're just gonna add to the shadows. And then we're gonna take a makeup blender and blend it in. And it kind of gives you a little bit of an upturned look. Because I have a bit of a prominent nose, like it's there. And so I just like sharpening the end of it. You know, I don't feel like I need a smaller nose, just sharper. This eyelash curler is terrible and I need a new one. I don't recommend it. I feel like every time I do a makeup tutorial, I say, this eyelash curler is terrible. Maybe you guys can leave some recommendations below for decent eyelash curler, because my eyelashes kind of just go straight out. Some of them even go down, it's sad. I'm gonna do some eyeliner. This is the Wet n Wild pen. I made it a little thicker at the ends to again pull up my eye. Now we're gonna use the Colossal Maybelline mascara, a total classic. Hello.
Hello.
Is everything okay?
Yeah.
Good.
Is everything okay in here?
Yeah. I figured I had time to show the peeps what I've been doing with my makeup.
Should I show them what I do with my makeup?
You're lucky, you just wake up and you go live your day. You don't have to wear makeup.
Well, it's not
that, I mean, I don't have to, but I choose to. Now we're gonna go in with Great Lash. I'm a little desperate for eyebrows these days, so this will hopefully not make them look so red. Now what I've been doing for lips is this same Maybelline lip liner I've been using since the original days of me being on YouTube. I think it's been 3 years. I'm gonna line those lips. If you guys do one thing to your look, I encourage you to line your lips. Now I'm gonna use the Revlon Color Stay. This is a little more pigmented than I was hoping it would be, so I just put one stripe on my bottom lip and then rub it, and then it kind of thins out the formula. Yeah, because it's like pretty pink. I recommend for going out to dinner or whenever you're gonna be drinking a lot or eating, these lip stains can be a lot better because they won't disintegrate as your evening goes on. It's not gonna end up on your glass or on your food or in your mouth. You know, you're not gonna be digesting it, so it's a really good option. And then I'm gonna finish off with the number 7 lash extender mascara. I started using this postpartum and I really like it. It definitely adds length and can get into those individual lashes.
What do you think, white or blue?
Blue what?
Blue. Should I go with black?
No, I think it looks good. Okay,
Now you can take the forehead tape off. I wish I should have showed you my wrinkle before. Maybe you'll see it. So you can see there's an outline of the tape. That won't last. So you can reuse the forehead tape a couple times before it loses its stickiness. And then after a while, it kind of gets like dead skin on it. This is the Rimmel Stay Glossy. I put this on top. I kind of wanted like a Barbie Kate Middleton vibe. Yeah, and you can see there's some frizz going on. So I'm gonna put an oil through my hair. Hopefully it'll take care of that. But also I wanted to show you, can you see that new growth postpartum hairs? Because I'm blonde, they're like smaller, but they're there. You can see, it's kind of exciting. My hair's growing back. Okay, and I don't have a powder on me. It's in the bathroom, so I'm gonna do that. Then I'm pretty much ready to go. Powder, hair oil, outfit. Yeah, this is the final look. It's kind of funny. It's like my 4-year anniversary and I feel better now in my like beauty, like in my look, you know, I feel better now, which is so crazy because I'm older, I've had a baby, but I'm just happier. Like my hair is healthier. I feel like my skin is better. My makeup skills are better. Like all these beauty products, you know, I didn't even use these like around the time I got married. I was kind of messy like around the time I got married. I've talked about it before, but I was going through a lot in my life and just didn't have as much time for this. So yeah, it's crazy. We're gonna be celebrating. I don't wanna say goodbye, love, or get ready with me's, but I got a jet.
Well, you call me husbear, so it's gotta be like dad bear.
Papa bear, that's Papa bear.
Papa bear.
You're my husbear, so always.
That's where I got bricks and bottles of pee thrown at me.
Oh my goodness.
That corner right there.
So horrible.
He's talking about the protests. Riots, not protests.
Wow, it's nice out. Is coming up.
Oh my gosh. I wonder if there's still birds living in this.
Probably.
It's like an old farmhouse.
Man, I took such good care of that place, and like it's all overgrown.
They have nice hydrangeas.
They probably don't even have fish in the koi pond.